suited up, but they're not fighting fires today.
In the city of Cape Coral, with all the canals we have, water training is almost as important for us as fire training is.
These probationary firefighters,
I like to help people, be there on their worst days, make it better,
are learning how to rescue people from the water.
Probably the hardest part of our job, I feel, is dive rescue.
How to search cars that have crashed into canals.
There's a lot of different, you know, hazards that we pay attention to.
And how to stay afloat wearing full gear.
There's always that little hesitation or the wide eye look at you at first, because that's not something you learn at the fire academy or things that are even talked about.
With more than 400 miles of canals, water is always an obstacle for Cape Coral firefighters. On any given day, a rescue could take them right to the water's edge or beneath it.
We've actually had firefighters fall into pools walking around the back of a fire. The smoke lays down to the ground where you can't even see that. Maybe you can't even see the canal that's behind the house.
Hence the importance of this training.
Roll forward, tuck your knees up, cross your ankles.
Fire gear is usually between 60 and 70 pounds dry. When it gets wet, it becomes much heavier than that.
The initial flip in, it did feel like I was going to sink for a second.
During this part of the training, firefighters learn how to save victims from the water and from a vehicle. All with an added layer of difficulty, low visibility goggles to mimic what most rescue and recovery missions are like.
Going into that canal that you were going in at 2-3 o'clock in the morning, it's going to be already black because it's nighttime. The water here is murky.
If you're diving in canals, you literally can't see the hand in front of your face.
While fighting fires is what they're known for.
When we get on scene and we see smoke, we see flames, we want to make sure there's no one inside, because that's our number one goal, is to save people.
The Cape Coral Fire Department's men and women wear many hats, but their overall goal is always the same.
To keep people safe and to save lives. I mean, and that's what I try to do every day when I come to work.
I'm in Cape Coral, Ashley Dyer, NBC2.